Okay. So, good day everyone. This is Engineer Armando Omanito and we will continue with our problem. So, upon solving all the x components and y components of all the lines, we will now check if our answers for each x component and y component are correct. So, simply, we will add all the x components of all the lines and it should be equal to 0. So, including their signs. And also with the y component. So, we will add all the y components of all the lines and it should be equal to 0. Okay. So, let us turn on our calculator. Okay. And then, let us first check if all the values in the x component of the lines will be equal to 0. So, including their signs. So, we have 59.45123 plus 79.16604, okay, minus 19.52333 minus 90.125 14 and then minus 28.96899. So press the equal sign and we have here negative 19/100,000, or simply the decimal equivalent is, press this button here, negative 1.9 times 10 to the negative 4, which is very near to 0. So, our answers in the x components of the lines are all correct. So, for the summation of the y components, so let us clear our calculator. We have 93.49969 minus 26.86428. Again, and then minus 125.38919, and then minus 26.66777, and then plus 85.42153. And then press the equal sign, and we have an answer of negative 1 over 50,000. Or, simply press this button, and the decimal equivalent is negative 2 times 10 to the negative 5. Okay, which is also very near to 0. So, the answers, or our answers in the summation of x component and y components of this table are all correct. So, the next thing to do is to enclose our closed tables inside a bigger rectangle. Okay, so for us to be able to compute for the area of this closed traverse. Okay. So, we will use the boundaries of the, or we will use the corners of the traverse lot as the boundaries of the bigger rectangle here. Okay. So, we use the boundary of, or the corner, or we use the corner A as the boundary of this vertical line. And corner B for the boundary of this horizontal line. Then corner C for the boundary again of this vertical line. And we cannot use the corner D for the boundary of this horizontal line. So we use corner E to be the boundary of this horizontal line. So we now have triangles and rectangle outside the closed traverse but inside the bigger rectangle. So the next thing to do is to plot the corresponding x components and y components of the lines. Like, for example, we have line AB, we have the x components here and the y components here. Okay, so we have the, okay, by the way, all the rectangles here are all right triangles. All the triangles here, sorry. All the triangles here are right triangles. So, we have the, for the line BC, we have the x component here and the y component here. So we will disregard the sign because we are going to compute all the for the areas of the triangles, of the right triangles. So the same with CD and so on. So from here, here we have area 4. We can form a we form a rectangle here, a small rectangle here. So that is, this is area 4. And then we have area 5, area 6. Okay. So the next thing to do is to compute for the areas of this right triangle and this small rectangle here. So here we will use the simple formula of the right triangle, 1/2 of its base multiplied by its height. So in area 1 we will get 2779.33579. So and then we will compute for area 2 here, the same formula, and area 3 here, another right triangle, and for area 4 we have a small rectangle, so that will be length multiplied by its width, so that is 26 point something multiplied by 19 point something, and then for area 5 and then for area 6. So after that, get the sum of all the areas of the right triangle and the rectangle. And that will be area 1 plus area 2, area 3, area 4 plus area 5 plus area 6. And that will be equal to, so the sum of all these areas is equal to 8026.3627. And the next thing to do is to compute for the area of this bigger rectangle. And that is equal to, so we have 93.49969 plus 85.42153. So multiplied by the sum of these two lengths here or two distance here. So 59 point something plus 79 point something. And we will get, and we can get the area of the bigger rectangle to be 24,801 point something. So to compute for the area of the closed traverse, simply subtract the area of all the right triangles here and the small rectangle here from the sum or from the area of the bigger rectangle, and that will be, so 24,800 point something for the area of the bigger rectangle, okay, here, minus the total area of all the right triangles and the rectangle, which is here 8026 point something, and the total area of the closed traverse will be 16,775.21731 square meter. So note that we did not use the process of DMD and DPD. We have used the simple methods in geometry for the area of the triangle and the rectangle. So this is Engineer Armando Omanito. I hope that you learned something in our lesson. Until next time, and may God bless us all.